What's up? I'm Adam.
I'm Kevin.
And in this video, we're going to look at deployment pipelines and what happens when the data set and the report are in different workspaces. And Kevin's got the answer. Let's do it. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both
Kevin,
Patrick, and this guy. All right, Kevin, thank you so much for joining us. It's a pleasure to have you.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Kevin helps us out on the live stream. He keeps track of the It Depends jar. If you don't come to our live streams, they're every Saturday morning at 9:30 a.m. Central. So, Kevin, in one of the live streams, there was a question there.
Yeah, Patrick asked me to write it down, so I put it on the box.
We got it on the box. All right, cool.
So the question was about using deployment pipelines with thin reports, meaning your report is in one workspace, and your data set is in another.
All right, enough of all this talking. You know, we'd like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to the machine.
All right, so here we are looking at Power BI service, and we have three workspaces for our data set: development, test, and production. This is on premium per user because deployment pipelines is a premium feature. This has been deployed all the way through, and you can see that by these green check marks. And this is the data set. You can tell because it's Contoso data, and each one of the workspaces have Contoso data. So we go over to our report, and you can see here that we have, in this case, only two workspaces set up for the report, a development and a test. We only have the one report. It is a thin report that is connected to the data set in development.
So in this case, we've got the data sets in development, test, production, and the report right now is just in development.
Correct.
And that report is connected to the data set that's in development as well.
Correct. Okay. And you could see that here with the development workspace being put together or shown here on the lineage.
Lineage is amazing.
Wonderful. All right. Everything is in development. So what we're going to do now is go ahead and deploy to test.
This is where the question came up. When we do this deployment of the report from development to test, even though the report is in the test workspace, it's still going to be bound to the data set in development, right? Because we didn't change anything.
Right.
So that's the theory that we're trying to prove or disprove, is what data set is it going to be connected to?
But through the magic of deployment pipelines, we're going to see how that works. All right, I'm going to click by deploy to test.
Yeah.
We get this nice little dialogue. We could add a note. We see only one report's going to move through. Let's hit our deploy button.
There we go. All right, it deployed.
It deployed. We'll go ahead and click on our go to workspace.
We can see from the top here, it says Contoso Reports PPU Test. We're in the test workspace, and we've got the report in the test workspace. So now, is it connected to the data set that's in development or test?
We go to lineage. Boom.
Oh my gosh, that's banana. Look at this. We can see the Contoso data set. It shows that it's in the test workspace for the data set. That is insane amazing.
It is. It's the magic of pipelines.
We didn't code anything. We didn't do anything. It just works when you deploy that report to the next stage. It knows to hook it up based on those relationships that existed previously because of the other relationships for the other workspace with deployment pipelines. That is...
It is unbelievable. And it's so good for you to get started with your data ops program of using deployment pipelines.
It's
this just works.
It's like Kerberos. It just works. Thank you for showing this. Thank you for proving it out. It meant less work for me so I can be more efficient. This is great. If you have any questions about this, if you played around with it, or do you have any more questions about deploying pipelines, you know what to do. Leave it in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And from
Kevin,
Patrick, and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.